Hello everyone. Today we are going to learn about still life study. Mostly it is called observational study. As the term suggests, it's all about observation. Whenever we see any object in front of our eyes and intended to draw on paper, we need to create an illusion of three-dimensional form on two-dimensional surface, which is the paper. We need to understand the relationship between the objects that we are going to draw. Three things we need to consider here: proportion of the object, aspect ratio, in-between distance. Here I am gonna make you understand how to see an object before you start your drawing. Here is my arrangement with a ceramic piece and a planter with a succulent. Now see, other than the succulent, both of my objects here are symmetrical objects. Now as we can see here, the height of the ceramic piece is shorter than its width. But how to measure that? Seeing the original 3D object, that is important. Hold your pencil steadily in front of your eyes. Do not bend your hand, so the distance between your eye and the pencil will be always same. Hold the pencil like this. Close your one eye and with the thumb, you have to measure the objects. Moving your thumb up and down, you will understand the variation of the heights and the distance in between the objects. Even placing the pencil horizontally, you can even get to understand the width and the aspect ratio of the objects. As we understand, both the ceramic piece and the terracotta planter are cylindrical form and accumulation of multiple circles. The ceramic piece has multiple ellipses and as well as the planter. Let's examine this. Another most important thing for drawing any symmetrical object is, if I put a central line, both the sides will be symmetrical. Here, these two parts are asymmetrical as the succulent is an organic form. So let's start with the drawing now. First, I am roughly plan the entire composition of these two elements before I start my final drawing. As my both the objects are symmetrical object, so first I put a central straight line. Draw this line freehand or you can use a ruler. After putting the straight line, first I need to draw one single side of that ceramic piece. From my eye level, the neck is placed a bit inside the main body of the vase. And the vase is short height that I need to keep in mind when I will draw this. As I always prefer to draw lightly so that it won't hamper my shading. Now after finishing one side, I have to start the measurement. For that, I have to put multiple horizontal lines parallel to each other. Here also you can use the ruler. And remember, this horizontal line has to be long enough to cover the other side. Following the curvature of my drawing, I have to draw all these lines. Now from this center line, I need to take the measurement of the distance from the vertical line to my linear drawing, following each horizontal line, and accordingly mark them on the other side. And to measure this, I have always found this pencil is very helpful rather than using ruler. This is much more handy. But it's entirely up to you whether you are going to use your pencil or the ruler. But for beginners, it's always helpful to use a ruler because ruler always gives you more accurate measurement. Thank you. Now see, we have got multiple points on the other side of the object following the parallel lines. Now, time to join them and I will get an accurate symmetrical middle line. This is the most authentic way to draw any symmetrical object. And if anyone follows this, you will be able to achieve perfection. Careful when you will draw the base. As I have explained before, both the objects are accumulation of multiple circles. This bottom base will also follow the same. Don't make it in straight line. Always for any cylindrical form, the base will be curved. Now when I am done with the drawing, I have to erase the entire measurement so my drawing looks clear. In my arrangement, as the terracotta pot is bit behind of the ceramic base, I will calculate the distance first. Yes. This will go perfect. Here I will repeat the same process for terracotta planter, and this one is much more easier to draw. Though the certain portion of the terracotta pot is hiding behind the ceramic base, but I will draw the entire pot first. It will help me to measure the pot correctly. So let's draw the succulent now. It's an organic form and irregular or asymmetrical. You don't have to measure anything except the height of the whole plant. Imagine a semicircle above the earthen pot and try to fit the plant inside. And you have to draw it all from your visual perception. And try to capture the characteristic of the plant through your drawing. My next video is coming up with the shading tutorial on this.